Let's vote for Lena. I want to explain you something. Es el agua de los You remember that toy? It was called Viewmaster. It was like a toy, like you put it in your eyes, and it has a slide. See, like a slides, and then you do like this. Do you remember? It was like a camera, but it was not a camera. It was like looking like a.
Ah, yes.
See?
Yes.
Do you remember this toy? And
yes.
Then you would put like a slide,
yeah.
And then it was like, it was
yes.
Round, right? And then you do like this, and a slide would pass, and a slide would pass, right?
Yeah.
And then you put it to sit over the light, yeah? And you could see the photos. Do you remember that?
Yeah, yeah. This is a
DR field. Yes. So imagine that you have this thing here in your eyes, right? So. So, if there is no light, see, that touches the slides, right? You cannot see the projection, isn't it? You cannot see the images. Am I right? But the images are there, or not? See, with or without the light, images are there, right? So, when the light is on, then you can see the images. So when the light is off, you cannot see the images. But the images are there. So, it is with the mind and the world. The mind is light, reflected light. The reflected light of the self is light that emanates from the self. Okay? So when the light of the self touches this light, which are the latencies, see the tendencies, patterns of behavior, all that stuff, right? So the world is perceived. And you are the seer. See, you are that, see? Now imagine that this is attached to you, see, that this is inseparable from you, right? And then imagine now that the light emanates from you, from the seer, see? The light emanates from the seer, right? And touches this light, projects that, and reflects that back to itself. So you are that, you are the source of that, see? You are the substratum in which they exist, right? You are the witness and the point of the solution. You are that. This is why mind is just light, energy, the reflected light of the self. That illumines all the patterns, see, of behavior. They are contained within the self, inseparable from the self. So all that together, collectively, the light, the mind, the patterns of behavior, all that is not different, separate, apart from the self. It is also the self. This is why there is not much that we can do about all this. See, but to leave it alone. The best thing we can do.
So, just leave it alone.
Leave it alone. Enjoy it or not. It depends. So when there are illumined, see, all these images interact with each other, am I right? They interact with each other, and they learn from each other and they grow. Right? You know what I'm saying? They change, they get modified, right? And then they rest. Then they illumine again, see? They wake up, they interact with each other, and they get modified, and then the light goes off and they rest. See? They are put at rest. See, they are back into its potential, their potential state. Right? And then they are activated again, see. This is why resting wakes up, interacts, learns, gets modified by this interaction and rest. See? You are a semi-scientist. Eh? You are a scientist, right? Even when to speak about Big Bang, right? That the universe didn't exist. That's not true. It existed in a potential state, right? Because what doesn't come into existence, see, what doesn't exist cannot come into existence. Any questions? Gosh. That is the way. See, you read books, you come to satsang, right? You listen to the teachings, right? And you think about it. That's okay. You see, I told you, you will find yourself, see, not being able to stop thinking about it. It's an example of an elephant that is giving a palm tree or is given a chain. So the elephant takes the chain and plays with it, right? What are we doing here is changing the toy. See, we change a material chain for a spiritual chain, right? Material knowledge or object for a spiritual knowledge and objects, right? And the mind now is entertaining itself with such concepts, right? Eventually, they will be dropped. See? Practice itself will help you to drop. And if you become a teacher, then all these words that I'm saying, see, they are driving me nuts. And they don't leave me alone until I speak them in satsang, right? Then I can explain. Otherwise, my consciousness will not leave me alone. I won't be able to sleep until I speak them out.
How is it possible to believe that this can be
stopped? Stop what?
This thinking process.
The thinking process never stops. See, what stops is a thinking process, see, that has the intention to repeat, see, the past. See? You experience something now, right? And that leaves an imprint in your mind, an impression, impresses. It's the meaning of impress you, see? Of impression. Impresses you, either positively or negatively, right? It's an imprint. Leaves an imprint in you, right? If you like it, then there will be the tendency, the inclination to repeat it, right? Or if you don't like it, see, there will be the tendency to avoid it, right? And they may happen again, and you try to avoid it, but you can't, see? And you may like to have them again, but you can't. And then, see, and so this fight between what is happening and what I want to happen or not happening, this fight, this struggle is suffering, right? And it is effort, right? Because in reality, this is happening effortlessly, right? The self is effortless, and the self is making everything to happen without making the slightest effort, because it is a power. See, it's a higher power that doesn't need to make an effort to make things to happen. It does it without desire or intention. Do you remember what is next? Without desire or intention, right? Without effort, without the need of knowledge, and without even knowing that it's doing it. Right? It explodes all these sort of itself. See, it wakes up the mind. See, it switches on the light, and illumines all what is within itself for its own sake. For the sake of the self. All this is for the sake of the self, not for the sake of a separate individual entity. Right? That's the meaning of the essence, one of the essential teachings of the Vedas. That from where all this universe exists. See? That on which all the universes exist. That by which, see, all, not by the mind, it's not for the mind, see, it's for that that this universe exists. See? And that on which all these universes exist, that alone is the self. And you are that. If your identity with the body that creates the idea that all this is for me. Even that is the self. Okay? Let's put it in that. Right? So the drama of life can take place. See, hello, how are you? I met this girl. I don't know, I haven't seen this girl before. Hello, nice to meet you. What are we talking about? See? All this drama is mental. See? All these relationships are mental. They are just words and thoughts. I love you and I hate you and I like you, but I don't. Better you find someone else. See, I like this one better. Right? All that stuff is imaginary. See, the individual is a myth. See? It's imaginary, right? Sometimes it's present, sometimes it's absent. And when it is present, it's just thought, right? I and you. Right? Hello, how are you? I am Caesar from Venezuela, and you are from? Ah, I'm from Russia. Oh, nice to meet you. And then, all that is imaginary, right? It is imagined by whom? That's the question. From where these thoughts are coming from? See? Who thinks I? From where this I is coming from, right? And it disappears. And you realize what? That you are neither the body nor the mind. So the I comes back, isn't it? The imaginary individual comes back. See? But now you realize it is not a separate entity, nor it is the world, right? Then you leave it alone. I cannot make it more clear than that. And then you let the imaginary individual self, see, the imaginary person, to play its role, whatever it has to play in this big drama. Here is playing Casimalasio. Here is playing. I think you know, figure out what is playing here, but something was playing. I don't know what is. Some of them play good guys. Some of them play bad guys. See, what to do? You don't play anything anymore, so you just remain as a witness. Your body is like a... See, sometimes lights in and out all the time. This is why in the past the sages used to live in the forest. See, they step out. See, this, even the physical form is taken out of, see, the game of good and evil. So the sense organs are the windows, see, the doors through which the self, see, enters into it, enters into the world. This is why people say the eyes, see, are the what? The windows of the soul, right? So you can see. The eyes cannot see. What sees is something different, right? It's not the body. And it's not the mind either, isn't it? So that which sees is that which is. But in reality, it's not that which sees only, because it hears it. That which is aware. So aware or conscious, right, is a world that involves the sense organs and more. See, because there are more organs than we don't know it. This body is like a Wi-Fi router. Wi-Fi router. It can receive more information than what you can possibly imagine. What happened is that too. And consciousness also, it doesn't even need the body. See, it can. Because it is omniscient, see, omnipresent is everywhere. So, if it wants to know something, it knows it. Without desire, right, or intention, without effort, without the need of knowledge, doesn't need to practice implementing the knowledge to do it, and without even knowing that it's doing it. Because it's not separate from what it's doing. See, doing and being are inseparable. So being is doing, doing is being.
What does it mean? Don't do anything. Just leave and suddenly it will happen.
The body will do whatever it's meant to do. See?
Mind
will not interfere. See? The mind will not interfere. See, because mind is impression. See, again, latencies, tendencies, positive, negative. I like it, I don't like it. See, I want it, I don't want it. See? So be honest with yourself and see how many things in your life that you didn't want to happen, they did happen anyway. Right? You didn't want them to happen and they did happen. See? And how many things you want them to happen and they didn't happen, right? So what is the use of wanting and not wanting? See, throw them away. What is the use of liking and disliking? Throw them away. It just makes you suffer, right? So ego is the cause of suffering, right?
Which is very understandable.
And identity with the body. See, it's I, this is what I remember. I am what I remember. I and my memory. I is also what I remember. I am told you are the body. So I remember, I am the body. And then you start accumulating, see, a story. This is me and the story of my life. Sit down and I will tell you while we're having lunch. Right? And what are you talking about? All what you remember. Whether it is pleasant or unpleasant, right? So the person is what? No, memory is your thought, right? This is me when I was a child, and this is me when I was in the army, and this is me going through hard times. I didn't want this to happen. See, and we prayed to God, but even though it did happen, right? And this is this girl in the school. I wanted that girl so much, but he wanted someone else. See, and I like her, but I couldn't have her. Right? Well, this is what, this is story, right? This is blah, 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 blah. Based on what? Memory, impressions, see? Images. What impresses you. When it didn't impress you, you didn't even remember. See, somebody will have to remind you. Remember when we were in the school, you may not even remember your fellow students. And they, oh, I forgot about you. Right? So these images were not that impressive. Then you couldn't care less. You only think about this, what impresses you. This is what I call impressions. What impacts you. And then you want more of that. Because it reminds you who you are as a separate entity, right? So it gives continuity to your imaginary sense of separate existence. So give life more energy, more food for the ego. This is why then the ego, see, starts controlling the behavior of the body, right? In order to keep that image. That's the question, right? Where are you and who are you when you don't think? From where these thoughts are coming from? This is I. So from where this I is coming from, right? From where the mind or the ego is coming from, it disappears. So who are you then? Who are you without thoughts? And who are you without body? See, this is the question that my teacher asked me. See? Who were your parents before they met? Right? Where were you before you were born? Before that body was born. Right? Where would you be before that body dies? Ask this question to yourself and say, who am I? It's a very dangerous question because it's going to kill you. Yo means ego. And this is also karma and this is samsara. See? Karma, samsara, repetitive stories. See? This constant activity, this constant effort. See? To repeat the same experiences again and again and again. See? Or to try to avoid them. This is why the sage, whatever comes, welcome. Pleasure, welcome. See? Pain, welcome also. Sometimes tasty food, right? Welcome. Sometimes, well, plain chapati. What to do? Let's eat plain chapati today. Huh? Tomorrow, nice food. Today, see, not nice food, isn't it?
What does it mean if somebody offering something for you, just like, let's do some business together. What does it mean? Should I accept it and go through this?
I don't know. It's going to be up to you. It's going to be up to you. If you are destined to do that, you will do it. If you are destined to do it, you will do it.
Destined.
If you are meant to do that, you will do it. If you are not meant to do it, you will not do it.
I shouldn't think about it and just let it be, nothing
more. Who is gonna let it be? Or who is not gonna let it be? Right? That's the question. See, the so-called individual free will is very limited, right? You have, see, the ego has a very limited freedom. It's like a cow. Remember the story of the cow that has a rope tied around the neck? Imagine that my body, see, there is a 20 meters length rope, right? And then this rope is attached to my neck. And at the other extreme of the rope is attached to a tree. And then this side of the tree, my God, is beautiful food, beautiful garden, beautiful girls, beautiful beaches, beautiful pleasures and all. And wonderful stuff. This is Wonderland here, right? This is Disneyland here, right? It's Mickey Mouse, Cinderella. All that stuff. Then, at this side of the tree, right, there is dirt and noise and ugly things and nasty people and evil, all that is there, right? Then I may be able to go to the left or to the right. I can choose to go to the left or to the light, to the left or to the right. But I will never go further than 20 meters. You know what I'm saying? See, I can go here or there, right? But no further than 20 meters. Now, what I call freedom of choice, which is the freedom to go to the right or to the left, is not even freedom. Because I'm going here or there according to my preconceived ideas, see, because of my tendencies. So there is not even freedom in the so-called individual freedom of choice. Right? Because it's limited to your memory. So how can we speak about freedom in any shape or form? Right? The self is not even free from this because it is not separate from itself. It has no choice but to be conscious of this. So what is the space for the word freedom and who is there to say it is free? So my ultimate understanding is that there is nothing to understand. Because to understand you need two. The one that understands and what is understood. And both things, the such thing, it doesn't exist. I know that I know nothing, right? And even that is to know something. Even that is to know too much. If you try to understand life with your mind, then you go bananas.
How? I don't have any instrument, tools, only mind.
Mind? Whose mind is it, right? Then you will understand. You will understand from elsewhere. As something else that is not the body and the mind. That's what I mean. See, repeating myself again and again and again until it exhausts you. In the mornings, in the afternoons, and sometimes at night. The ego is like a parrot that repeats the same thing and over again. Far from coming from its own, his or her own experience. So to remain motionless, it's only for times, for some time, until the tendencies disappear. Then
it sometimes can take full life.
So what? You will have no choice. I'm telling you, you will be left with no choice. See, because even if you are destined to be a self-realized, you won't be able to stop until the game is over. See, because even self-realization is preordained. Right? What to do? Now, more you surrender, so then see, there is a change in your life. This is difficult to explain. You have to experience it by yourself. See what happens when you surrender. And you surrender your identity with the body. This is what you surrender, your ego. The idea that my reality is separate from the that my reality is limited to the body. Not that I am not the body, that my self is not limited to the body. I am also the body. See, the body is also the self. The mind is also the self. See? Remember, you are not one but three. See? Now, how can I remember all that? See? Because I'm saturated. Right? Because I went on and on and on and on and on and on. You see why? See? Also, I trusted my teachers. See? Not that I believe them, I trust them. And then when I was here, I was just. I read this from the book yesterday, right? See, you read about God, see, you think about God, you talk about God, see, His teachings, see, and the practices prescribed by deeds, and you read it and then you practice. See? Practicing help you to understand and the knowledge. See? Practicing, reading, understanding a little bit more. Practicing, reading, understanding, right? Realizing, understanding means realizing that what the scripture says is true. It starts becoming your experience. Right? this truth. See, if I practice, the result is this. If I surrender, the result is this. Right? If I don't think, then I realize that I am not devoted. See, practice and reading, practice and reading. Right? Eventually, you throw the knowledge and you throw the practice. See? And then you won't stop thinking about it because you will teach, right? And this is what happened to Ramana, see? When he wrote 40 verses about reality, see? He said, this thought were coming to me, I tried to get rid of them and I couldn't, see? And they keep on coming back and I tried to get rid of them and I couldn't. Then I wrote them in a piece of paper and they left me alone. And sometimes 1 o'clock in the morning or whatever, I have to put it here in my phone, right? Sometimes I don't even need to do it. See, sometimes it just stays in my head and I come here, speak it out, and this is what you say, oh, thank you. That was the answer to my question. I didn't even need to ask the question, right? See? They don't leave me alone until it's your fault. Because you have the question, you don't know the answer, and then I have to face the consequences of it. Now ask me, how does it happen? And say, I don't know. See, without intention or desire, without effort, see, without the need of knowledge, see, without even knowing, it just shows up and then it comes out. That's all.
Sometimes when you listen,
I'm like
in the room.
And then and poof. Go on.
No, it's like in the moment,
I couldn't
understand.
See, let me see if I understood what you mean by because I have to, see, even I have to learn, I have to use my supernatural powers to understand this language from I don't know which planet. It happened to me. Let me see, it is similar to what you experienced, right? Sometimes I was listening to Mr. Ratanlal, to my teacher, talking, right? And at some point, see, what he was talking about didn't mean anything, right? Why? Because I was just conscious of pain, see? Nothing wrong with that. So, by listening these words, see, you are placed back in your natural state. Sometimes people get crazy with me because they say, see, sir, and talk. And what's the matter? Why you people are making so much noise? And it sounds by the energy that they speak about, there is an emergency, something is happening terribly, nothing, it's just the ego creating an imaginary, so what's the matter? See? Like a child is crying, and then you see, does it ache? No. Is the child hungry? No. Is it sleeping? No. See, is it sick? No. Then why so much noise? Right? Ego, see, you think that the baby doesn't have ego? Take a toy from the hands of the baby. Right? Then I want more. See? Why? Because they brought this identity back here. See, at some point, I started and said the tendencies are there. And the tendency, even to identify with the body, is there, right? It just wakes up. See, the tendency is there and then it gets manifested. Right? And then mom and papa will reinforce that, see? So the ego that is in the father will reinforce the ego that is already growing in the child. And if his mom and papa are super enlightened beings, the child is going to be exposed to the environment, see, that can, see, pollute the mind of this child. So, welcome to planet Earth. This is how things happen here, right? But if the ego is gone, you don't come back here again. See, there is a, there is some kind of a energy body that remains or something, right? And it goes elsewhere according to whatever destiny may take place. It may sound like mambo jambo, what I'm talking about, right? It may sound like a very spiritual lecture and concept. No, it's a description of fact. This is my thought. Anyway. So, this is not dullness. See? This is not dullness. No, this is not dullness. But,
meeting with the
whole. No, no. You find yourself just conscious of pain. See, when I was doing the inquiry in the mandir, see, when consciously, see, one enters into this state, right? Just not a state, but Sai Baba was there. And he was no longer attractive. So, see, it is oneself which is attractive, see. What we really are is attracted to what it really is. You understand? What I am was attracted to what I am. See? And then you realize everything else is what? See, it's just a dream, it's just images, it's just an image. This is why it's called an image in consciousness, right? That emerges from consciousness, see, and emerges from you. See, exists in you, to be witnessed by you, and disappears within you. The self, right? This is why you are looking here and there. And even the body, see, the body, you put the body in front of you, see. You see, these are dream bodies. But if you put your foot in front of you, you realize that your body is also a dream body as any other dream body. That was my experience, see. See, I was doing it like this. Yeah, it was first funny. Sometimes I was in a social meeting with my friend, and I was talking and I was looking at them, and I believe I found myself like testing, doing especially like this with my legs, and I said, am I going bananas? And I look at my feet, right? And I said, my God, in the same way, I am not this person in front of me, I am not this body neither, but somehow it is like attached to me mainly, right? But the same thing that is here is there. See? I am you. Right? And you are him. Right? The one appears to be many. So the individual, who is the individual? Is any individual person there? Having a relationship with another individual there? Or is one being having a relationship with itself? Playing forgetfulness of itself to be able to play, right? Separate individual being, having a separate individual life with a story and passport and birth certificate and the rest of it. I was born 5th of July 1969 at 9 p.m. Please, can you make an astrology chart? I want to know my future. And if the present is good, they tell you your future. Then, your future is already written. Then, let it run. See, if there is identity with the body, you will be affected, see, by destiny. Right? Otherwise, destiny doesn't touch you. The karma doesn't touch you. Right? Samsara doesn't touch you. So nothing like satsang to cross the ocean of samsara. See? What is satsang? Self-awareness. See, association with the self means disassociation with the body. And then you can cross the samsara, which is birth and death, life. See, this is samsara. From birth to death, this is a process, right? And then you go through that, completely unaffected by the activities of your body, your mind, or the bodies of the people's mind. So,
I would like to tell about one experiment. In Sweden, there is a scientist who works with the brain.
I know.
When they put small body and remove the mind from the, it's like illusion. After some time, you start to feel this body of the toy like your body.
Yeah, and then you start feeling every body, see, you become what you are aware of, right? And then you start feeling, oh my God, what is happening here, see, right? You become what you are conscious of, right? And this is empathy, see, this is empathy. Empathy. See, neurologists explain that, right? This is something called mirror neurons, right? Mirror neurons. Am I right? If there is ego, they don't work properly. See, there is neuro disconnection, right? And then it's only I, me and myself, see, you don't feel other people's pain, you don't feel other people's suffering, see, you don't know what is compassion, you don't know what is empathy, you don't know any of that stuff, see, because it's ego. So when the ego disappears, there is neuroconnectivity, right? See, so my neurons are connected actually with your neurons, see, everything is connected, right? So maybe the ego has had a playful role, but it's simply disfinished. That's the problem with the ego, the question about the ego. See, it's on the way out. Forget about it. Stop thinking about the ego. Get rid of it. Let's move on. See, to the next stage of evolution. That's evolution also, right? Human beings are becoming a new species. Right? See, we can walk on two legs. See, we can, and we can remain straight. Right? We have been going back to our hands. See? We can use the thumb. Before we couldn't. Yeah? Now we have less hair in the body. See, we are not climbing trees and stuff. It's evolution, right? Human beings still have a little bit of the monkey mind, right? So you leave the monkey mind, see, and then you are a human being. This is why people don't consider humans animals, see? You are not an animal, you are a human being. Right? This is why they say like that. So maybe humans are GMO also, genetically modified. Okay. And we became something else, right? By internal forces, external forces, whatever the reason it may be, right? Humans are becoming something else. Moving towards something else, right? So, maybe later, who knows? After you get your visa. This is the Sara, the festival. So it lasts for longer than I thought. Then the lawyer won't be able, even if the lawyer wants to help you, he can't because the public offices will be closed. So he won't be able to help. So you have to wait. He will, he already proved that he can deliver, right? And we can trust him. No problem. Bhagavad said, life is a game, play it. Don't take it too seriously, but it's a game, play it. Life is a challenge, accept it, right? Accept it. It's a challenge, accept it, you go through it. Right? Life is love, then live in love also. No? I am playing a role, you are playing a role. See, this is a role also that is played, right? And this role is not more spacious than any other role. It's like any other role, right? The difference between this role and any other role is that this role, see, is for you to know that you are playing a role, right? You know, all the teacher says, be like an actor in the scenario. See, play, you are playing Juliet, right? And then after the play finished, do you go on, oh, Romeo, Romeo, I'm suffering for you, Romeo. No, right? And then, see, when the day finishes and you go home, then, see, remain as you are. In the meantime, pretend to be you're something and someone else. Why not? Act properly so you can get a, become an Oscar winner. So people that judge positively or negatively, they are lost in the role they're playing. See? They think this is real and they believe the role, the identity is the role, they are what they think. And also let them, right? You just make sure that as long as you know you are playing your role, let everybody else be. Baba says, this is why I love him so much. He was so funny. And the way he was teaching was hilarious. Very light and alive. He says, see, you go to a movie, see? And then there is a heroine and the hero, right? And then the heroine cries for the hero and the hero fights for the heroine. See, and then both fight and cry, right? See, they are paid for that, see? But you go and pay to cry, see? They are paid to cry and you pay to cry, right? The heroine is acting, oh, Juliet, right? And Romeo, oh, no, whatever, Romeo, oh, Juliet, and Juliet, oh, Romeo. They are paid to cry. Then you watch that and you also cry, see, for you are paying to cry. This is not real. See, this is like a matrix actually. This is like a matrix. Then step out of it. Leo. I'm telling you, you become such a good listener. Oh my God. And if you don't realize yourself, see, if you don't understand this, then you won't survive what is coming next. Okay? The chaos that is coming is the ego will not survive, simple as it. You will have to be destroyed also physically. Right? They will leave and the egolessness will remain. See? And this egolessness will create a new world. You have visa until when, Sash? Until when you have visa?
Until 19th of December.
Do you have the chance to go out, extend it, and come back? Get fresh visa and come back?
I don't know yet because it depends on my
Baltic Sea is a very dangerous place to be now. Baltic Sea, Black Sea, very dangerous place. What is it? Anybody? Black Sea, Baltic Sea. Hola, Papi, come. Come. Come, you finish satsang today. The next 20 minutes you give it. Come. Come. Come, Papi, come. Come. Eleven. Today is Saturday. And the after tomorrow, Monday. Yeah, you're very much aware. Tomorrow I'm going to the barber. Barber shop. Need to cut the grass. Need to go to the garden and to cut the grass. Until I get a machine or something. See, it's so funny when sometimes you listen to people, there is something, how they interpret the teaching. See, Krishna said to Arjuna, the self is in the tip of your nose. You meditate on yourself. And then people then start looking at the tip of this. It's a form of meditation, it's a formal form of meditation when people meditate in the tip of their nose. See, the only thing that you will get there is cross-eyed and a headache. Right? In the tip of your nose means it is very close. Right? It's right there. It means it's right there and it is who you are. And they make a retreat of meditating on the tip of the nose. 300 euros per person, in food included and accommodation. Food and accommodation included. Look within. And then you get spiritually cross-eyed. Very good, very deep. Juliana? Well, tomorrow is Monday, you give that. Why not? Monday. To whom? Monday, you answer the questions. Why not? But I will not share the donation with you. See? Because they are coming from you. So. Don't thank me for something, you have to say thanks to her. Without her, I wouldn't be here. She's the one that is basically responsible for the whole story. This is why I'm working so much, because I have to justify the salary that my boss is paying to me. See? So I have to work to justify the money that I'm... No, otherwise she will fire me. Right? You're not working enough hours. See? I'm paying you for full time, satsang, you are given only half time. Part-time job. They're paying you for full time.
Fight because we still didn't get light. You are not well.
I'm not working properly. Don't worry, tonight I will practice harder so I can become a better teacher. Maybe you can meditate on the tip of your nose. Is he crying or laughing? You will not get it. Remember, it's not an achievement. It is what you are already, right here, right now. So, songs to Allah. That's a very good strategy. You call them 5 times a day. Right? Not to forget. Right? Muslims, I think they do it 5 times a day, right? They sing. And this is calling the devotees to the main, to the church, to pray. India also, right? That reminders everywhere, basically. Every time. So there is no forgetfulness of oneself in one's reality. In Miami, I don't know. In Miami, see, Mickey Mouse. Disneyland, see. Fantasyland. What is it? People even celebrate Mickey Mouse birthday. Can you believe that? It doesn't even exist, or even exist. It's such a fuss about Mickey Mouse birthday. And then everybody goes like fools, wearing a stupid hat with his ears. Even grown up people. For how long such a culture can survive then? It's not even a culture, it's a subculture. If you want to know what is the real culture of North America and South America, go and talk to the Indians. Not to the colonizers that created a subculture. Superman, Wonder Woman, Aquaman. Do you remember these cartoons? Such a brainwash, right? So you start worshipping such a nonsense since you're a boy. It's a systematically, it's a brain systematically, see, brainwashing. To worship idiocy. To become an idiot, right? Once we become an idiot, let's be honest, right? You are also from my region, no? Colombia, Venezuela, same. No? And I was watching, remember these cowboys movies, right? So they were trying to make us believe that the cowboys were the good guys and the Indians were the bad guys, right? We nearly bought that nonsense, right? And then, no, it is the other way around. See? I come from Venezuela. Columbus arrived in Venezuela first. Right? He stopped in Margarita Island, where I grew up. Right? And then there is a small, very small island. See, there's a state called Margarita Nueva Esparta. It's a state. Nueva Esparta. New Esparta. They call it like that. Venezuela, even Venezuela don't have an original name. So Venezuela, see, the name Venezuela is not even Venezuelan. See, still, it has a name given by the colonizers. Venezuela means little Venezia, right? Because when the conquistadors, colonizers arrived in the delta, see, the Orinoco, the delta, the river, see? It goes to the Orinoco and all that. They saw how the Indians were living, see, in houses that were sticking out of the river, see, four sticks, and the house was on top, and they said, oh, they were like a, in a very humiliating way, see, Venezuela, like a little Venezia, see. And there is a statue, there is a town called Macuro, see, which is where Columbus put feet for the first time in mainland, see, and the name of the place is Macuro. Right? Because it's near Delta Macuro, see, the delta. And there is a statue of Columbus there. And in the school, see, you believe that this guy was a hero. He was not a hero, he was a pirate from the Guim, right? And he was coming to our land to take all the richness and send it back to Spain so the Queen could carry on, see, taking more land for herself. And then they arrive in a place called Margarita Island before arriving to the mainland. And then in a small island called Cubagua. Right? And it's a beautiful place. It's on one side of the island. There's a wonderful coral reef. And so there was so much food was there. Right? The Indians were living there. They were called Waikeries. And at the other side of the island, there was a endless blank, endless carpet, see, of mother pearls. See, when you take the pearls, it was full of seaweed and mother pearls. See, it says kilometers and kilometers, you endless mother pearls. And they discovered that. And they created a city called Nueva Cádiz, right? And they were taking the pearls from there, sending them back to Spain, see, to sponsor the more colonization and more boats and more. But something happened, see, an earthquake took place. And the city that they built it sank. The boss. And then they went to Venezuela. Right? So, then from there starting moving up and down, see, up North America, down South America. And then Colombians, all these people suffered the terrible evilness of the colonizers. And they change our culture, remember? You don't remember because, you know, maybe you are too young. So they make the Aborigines to forget who they are and the way they were living, right? Until now. Well, there are some Aborigines that they haven't forgotten. And they created a subculture, see, they rewrote the history. And people identify themselves as this. This is who you are, this is how you are, this is how you were, etc., etc., etc. And I came with already a distorted version of Christianity. I don't imagine Jesus, see, going all over the world, see, conquering anybody and using his the name of God to kill anybody and to, see, to take anybody's land, anybody's life, and so on. So, this is when, since I am a child, I said, something smells fishy here. This is not, I don't understand. I'm buying this for a second. And then, since the child, I am curious about, see, what is this all about? Right? What is this all about? And then the question changed. See, you mature, what is the truth? Because this makes no sense. The way people are living makes no sense. And they want me to live like that? I'm sorry, I can't. Apparently, the maps were not even originally from Columbus. Apparently, these maps were from somebody else. People said that they were from Amerigo Vespucci, an Italian fellow. And Columbus got lost. See, he was not even that good. He was going this direction and end on the other side. He wasn't that intelligent. He's a great man.
Looking for India.
I think he was looking for this India.
Yes.
And then he found,
yes.
Whoops, something wrong with the GPS. And maybe the maybe the electromagnetic field affected the GPS of Columbus and then landed at the other side of the world. India also, this India also, right, still is recovering from the damage created by the British Empire, right? It is recovering from the stage of poverty that most of the people were left, right? Recovering, still regaining their culture and their principles and all that stuff. Right? Anyway, I feel like I am more Indian than anything. Somehow, I see. I don't know why. Maybe from previous life. Maybe from North India because I don't like rice. I like chapati. And this is from North, it's more than. Maybe this is why my nose and my teeth, maybe, I don't know, maybe, who knows. Who knows. Such a rich culture, see? So much wisdom, so much knowledge. See? Basically, all the knowledge that we have came from here. Mathematics, arithmetic, even they invented the zero. So much. And apparently all these countries around were part of Bharat, like Russia and all these countries were one huge kingdom, see, run by different kings and all that stuff. Very interesting thing. This is why you have this argument that Russia says, no, the Vedas are coming from Russia, they are not coming from India. Then Ukraine said the same thing, and Lithuanian also said the same thing. No, see, the Vedas come in, the Vedas say, who cares? I'm happy that they came into existence. See. There's more there. The thing is, see, all these technologies and all this, we don't know. All these flying objects and all that stuff, who knows? We don't know. I may have a little idea, but I don't like to talk too much about it. Otherwise, people think I am cool. So let's keep it low for now. We are not the only ones. See, human thing that not at all. There's more. It's more than what we can possibly imagine. So, many rooms are in the house of the Lord, right? Where the Lord lives in the universe. See, this is His house, right? And there are many rooms, right? And within those rooms are a lot of stuff. The thing is that we don't know it, right? But there is more than what you can imagine. See, and then in one room there is such, and in another room there is such. There is more than. Slowly, slowly, all that will come to the surface. So, 6:30. I cannot work more than after 6:30 because then she will have to pay me extra hours. And it's double. Yeah, we cannot stop. See you on Monday. See, tomorrow is holiday because even God rests on Sunday. So, see you on Monday.